I'm asking a very direct question to the superintendent of our school. Is there a policy that allows, is there a policy that allows?
I can either confirm or deny.
I will ask the full question, and then you confirm or deny. Ready? Is there a policy within our district that allows any teacher or administrator or principal or vice principal to physically touch and frisk a student?
Mr. Bradley, again, you're asking a question regarding a situation.
No, I'm asking a straight question.
There is no, are you asking for a policy?
Is there a policy number that allows?
The procedure is for our principals, administrators, and teachers act in good faith to keep our schools safe and secure at all times.
Excellent. Is there a policy or procedure that allows anyone of our employees to touch and frisk a student?
Again, I can either confirm or deny.
I think you guys are in a world that we better get this policy straight, because we're violating it according to what you're saying and according to what you're just demonstrating.
Well, you just said there is no policy.
Which means he did not act within the policy of the district.
How do you violate a policy that doesn't exist?
By touching a student. So now you're telling me the loophole is if there's no policy? All right, let's get started fresh. Missy, I'd like to add, I make a motion that we add a policy. I make a motion that we add a policy that this allows our employees to touch students. You won't do it?
I don't agree with that.
Well, you would do it or not?
No, I would not do it.
Why wouldn't you do that?
As Mr. Claver stated, the whole procedures and policies are meant to withhold the safety of the students. That jeopardizes the safety of the students.
There's not jeopardizing. So the safety of the student is the one that's being frisked. The next one is the discussion of the handbooks. We decided that they were gonna have a meeting.
Open meeting, yes.
They're gonna open the meeting. When is that going to occur?
We are going to look, I'm gonna check now that we're in school. I talked to Mr. Tack today. We're looking to do our academic affairs, which is October 3rd, in place of that.
And where's that meeting gonna be held?
Hold it here.
And what time is it gonna be held?
What time is it usually?
Five,
same time.
We want parents to attend this. Why don't you move it to a more reasonable hour? You barely made it home from work to get here at 5:45. If the president of our board can't make it 5:45, how are we gonna get there? Seven? And that's when the school board meetings are, right?
I don't care.
Does 7 PM work for you, Mr. Tack?
Yeah, okay.
And then we're gonna publish the handbook to the community, and we're going to allow the community to attend.
They're online now.
Okay, so we're gonna announce, how are we gonna announce this meeting? We're gonna use robocall?
We'll have to advertise.
We're gonna advertise the meeting, right? You're gonna robocall it, you're gonna send out letters? Just like Title I, are we gonna send a letter? We want people to attend, we want people to use Title I, we want people to have a conversation on our handbook.
You can email.
You're not gonna get right in the email.
I would go to the letters, because they get. Do an email. You do email.
You can do email to the community? How are you gonna do an email to a community?
Just robocall. How are you gonna robocall the community?
That's available to us.
Not the whole community, the school community.
Hold on, slow down, one at a time. How do you robocall a community? Very easily, you can robocall an entire community. That's not an issue. You can pick a geographical location and you can robocall the entire district. You can.
How do you robocall an entire community?
Just like you do in an election. You say, I wanna have these calls. What's that?
Who's gonna do?
The district. Yeah, you can, just like you do with robocall or anything else, you can set it up.
Who's setting it up?
How do you do your robocall now, Mr. Claver?
It's all set up through the program.
Right, so what do you do? You added the telephone numbers in, Mr. Claver?
No, it's all through info snap. The parents, when they register their kids.
Okay, so the numbers are in. The numbers are available. It's a database. You can add it in instead of info snap.
Type them all in.
If you don't have, you're acting like Mr. Obstruction. Here, go like this a little more, because it really just makes the money.
It's a
database. You can pull the database.
It's community and parents, I see.
That. Yeah, you do it all the time. You have a database of numbers. You push the button that says upload, and you grab all those numbers, and you throw it into a file, and then it robocalls, just like it does now. You don't think you physically type them in every time, correct?
Like I said, we have a program that does it for us.
Correct, and you can buy a database.
So now I have to purchase them.
You can buy a database. Do you want people to attend?
No.
We will contact by a database. Parents of students.
students.
Yeah, parents.
How about if I hand you the database and it's free?
First of all, I'm not taking the privilege of calling everyone in the community.
And telling them that they have a, their government is having a meeting about their policies and their handbooks.
I will contact the parents in the Lehighton educational community and let them know through our principal. Yeah, but I'm not recommending that I contact.
You're going to advertise it in the paper.
Yes.
You're going to do a robocall to the parents, right?
Parents and community, it's on the website. Educational community, it's on there. Post it on the website.
And then you're going to have a, you have an email?
We can do an email.
And if I gave you a list of numbers to call, will you upload them onto your robocall?
It's a robocall for our students, and then what, like for school information. I'm not putting anyone outside of our district on our robocall.
You're not putting them on your robocall. You're putting you on the robocall. I'm just giving you more numbers to use for your robocall. A database of numbers.
I don't like those numbers anymore in our robocall system.
It's a separate database, Mr. Cleaver.
You have to upload it into our calling system.
Correct.
That takes a chance to contaminate someone.
Contaminate how, Mr. Tack?
You don't know if it brings a virus.
You know what the greatest part about ignorance is? It breeds fear.
You know? I'm not afraid, I'm just saying.
Well, then what are you worried about? It's a set of numbers.
Nothing. Because you never know what happens. Never say never.
That's ignorance and fear. Thank you.
No, thank you.
So we'll do 7, we'll make it for 7 o'clock.
Sure.
So just move to adjourn.
Yeah.